Good morning, morning glory. Good morning, watch a story. I love that song from Glen Campbell and Bobby Gentry. Gotta be old like me to remember it, but of course you can probably hardly hear it because I'm looking right over my fence here. It's like I'm out in the country, but not really. Good morning. What I wanted to do today was show you a couple things I got going here. Dale Calder, look what I got going. Is mine beating yours? I don't know. This is a contest, but I'm not doing all that well. This is a Sugarbaby watermelon, and Dale and I have a little race. And I don't know if I'm going to win, but mine's right by my compost pile. See the compost pile over there? So I've got it right on the outside of it, and I suppose I should put more compost in there, but we'll see. I think I did when I planted it. I've got this one growing in a barrel. Well, we'll see. And this one is actually straight in the dirt. Now, the dirt really isn't good there because it's mostly like sand, see? What happens in California, it goes back to like desert-like. But anyway, I'm giving it a try this way. One in there and one in there. And I'm going to put it up on these posts. Now, these are tent posts. We used to have a 12-man tent. And so what I did was I put them up here. You know how it's got this little metal piece? So, you know, you pull it apart, then you can fold it up real small. So I thought, oh, they never seem to die. They're made out of plastic or something. So I'll just put them right here. So I stuck them in there. And this bed, this bed is not doing well because it only gets the sun every once in a while. During June in Southern California, we have a thing called June gloom. Although it's July, not knowing that June is over. And the sun comes up over there. See, it's just starting to come out now, but it doesn't come out till about noon for the longest time. And of course, then around noon, it's about here, right? Well, then at noon, it starts, there's all the trees. And the trees, you know, covered up. So it would get a lot of morning sun when there's no clouds. So it would get a lot of morning sun, but anyway, so around noon, and then a little later, it might come. The sun might come through here a little bit, but oh well. Okay, so I've got this going. This is Sugarbaby watermelons, and there is a blossom. I don't see any Sugarbaby melons yet, but I think this blossom may be the first, which is a good to have it right there. I can hold it secure, and if I need to, I'll put some more sticks across branches. I mean, from my trees. Not like I don't have enough of those. Okay, come over here. I want to show you something so cool. All right. See all these things? I'm sorry. I shouldn't bounce. Sorry. See all this stuff that comes from that tree. And if I blow this away today, it'll all be back tomorrow. So I only do it like a couple times a week. Are you guys playing still? Jeez. All right. Now the worm castings, I went through the other one and I got the other worm castings out and it was clear to the top. And so then I kind of threw it back in to help the formula, you know, like start all over again. So the worms are all happy now, and they're eating up a storm. I was going to go through all of these and get out any other worms or whatever, but I think I'll work my way down towards the bottom where I'm sure I'll find some worms and then put them back. But I had a butter dish, so I've used all of this from right here, too. It was right there all the way down so far. And here's what I did with them. Let's go over here. I'll try not to bounce, but I'm kind of a bouncy person. Everything on me bounces when I move. Don't visualize that. All right. So now, a while back, like a month ago or so, I planted the most gorgeous, healthiest looking peppers in this little area right here. Now remember, I got this dirt from the building supply place, which was half topsoil and half compost. And when I got it, it's like I put tomatillos and I put things in it and nothing grew. It was like something's wrong with the dirt. The same time I put the tomatillos in there, which I left one there, I put these in my raised bed. And they're huge. And I got a bunch of them on there. So there was something wrong with that dirt. And I've been trying to amend it and everything, do everything I can to it. And I was actually afraid to plant anything in it, but at this point I just had to. So I planted in an eggplant, which I don't know if it's good next to tomatoes, but I don't care right now. I want something to grow in there. These peppers were our mini, they're like little yummy snacking sweet peppers. Grows 2 to 3 inches, orange pepper, very sweet. And I hear they're really good. So I got those at the store. And they were, like I said, perfect. Now, the leaves are all yellow, and I'm thinking, you know, of course, it could be overwatering, but it seems to get really dry before I water it, so I don't know. But I think it has something to do with the soil. I think I heard John Kohler say that one time that they put sewage sludge in buildings, material places sometimes. I got a great big bulldozer, about killed myself putting it all in there, but I'm going to make it work. I'll show you the other plants I planted. I planted this. Now that's a healthy looking pepper. I was afraid to plant it. I just want it to grow well. The sweet banana pepper and this sweet banana pepper. Now I planted this one and that one and this eggplant and these yesterday. That's what I planted yesterday. These have been there for a while. So my point is that I've got a butter dish, and I filled it full of, in an empty butter dish, I filled a container, crocks, you know, I filled it full of worm castings, and when I planted this, I made a nice big hole. This, by the way, on top here now is that super soil garden, I don't know, amendment or something. It's not potting mix, but garden something. And so I put that on top, but then I had that on there for a while. So yesterday what I did is I dug a nice big hole and I put the worm castings in there and I mixed it all up with the dirt. And then I planted that because I see that seeds in my compost bin, my worm compost, grow really well. So I think you can't have it too strong, but that's my opinion at this point. We'll see. Now this is a healthy looking one from the store. It's been in a pot for like a couple weeks. And I did the same thing. One hole, butter dish of worm compost, dug out a big hole, put it in there, mixed some dirt with it a little bit, but never went too far. I made the hole about that big. Now these other things do not have the worm compost. The celebrity and this is eggplant. Those I planted after I put the super soil mix down. So they do not have worm compost at this point. They probably should, but for right now I'm doing an experiment. I want to see if those grab on. And I did the same thing with this. I did a big hole like this. And then I pushed the other stuff aside. And then I put a big thing of worm compost, mixed it all up in there. That's, you know, and then hopefully it's not going to turn all ugly. But, you know, it finally did kind of turn out for me here. It did grow. So, and I do have those black crim right there. These are black crim and black prince and this is Black Prince in this container here. And is that a Black Prince right there? It's a weird looking tomato. Black Prince. Are they? Oh no. Here's a Black Prince. This is a big one. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, that's the size of. Oh, I think I can pick that right now. Oh yeah. Ooh, it's juicy. Black Prince. So I'm going to try that. Put this over here on my outdoor chair. And I'll pick, these are black crim. Well, I'll have to do that later. I have to move some wood. Okay, so there we go. What else is going on? Let's see. That same time I did that Sugarbaby watermelon, I planted this one over here. It gets the afternoon sun amongst the weeds, which I have to take out. And that Sugarbaby is not doing well, but we'll see. Of course, there's a big dog print right there. I gotta get all these weeds out of here. Anyway, I wanna, not kill myself. I'm gonna pick my strawberries and I'm gonna have me a nice breakfast. I think I might have some cereal in there. Put them in the cereal. Yeah, that's gonna be good. All right, you have a nice day. You didn't get to see the doggies, but they're napping. So you guys can see this doggie. Good morning, morning glory. God, I love that song. Bobby Gentry and Glenn Campbell. Good old days.